want to slip into your slippers, melt into your mold. Wake up with your worries, watch your fairy tales unfold.
I loved the concert. Jackie was fabulous.
You know, she really is fabulous, and I love going to see her perform because every time she sings a song, it sounds different, every performance. But, you know, it's a little bit of improv and a little bit of what you know and what you love.
She's mesmerizing. I mean, it was phenomenal.
The sound of Jackie's voice, it's very intimate. It's deceptively quiet. I mean, she can sing with a lot of power, but you still feel like you're standing right next to her.
If I had a way, I'd sweep it across your shoulder and make it touch the thing you covered in your dreams. But I got just these arms, too tired to open wide enough to wrap around your wide shoulder love. Maybe if you close your eyes and let your memory steam, you'd see me better in the dark. Stay and watch me sleep.
I was at a NARIS screening committee where you have to go through hundreds of CDs. And I had a stack of vocal CDs, and I was going through one after the other after the other. And I popped it on, and I stopped dead in my tracks. From the very first note, the voice was so sensual and so striking, so unique, that I had never heard a voice like that before.
You know, I look at our roster of singers, and I'm very proud of the roster that we've developed, you know, starting with Diane Reeves, who signed with us in 1987 and is still with us now. Soon thereafter, we signed Cassandra Wilson, and then out of nowhere came Nora Jones. It's quite a roster of individual talents, and when you hear those voices, they're all immediately different. You hear one note and you know who they are. And the same is really true with Jackie. And that's really the sole reason why we signed her. I think when you hear a voice that is distinctive, that has a signature on it, that has that kind of magic, plus she's able to interpret a lyric like very few other people, you know you have a real artist. And that's what we want, and that's what we have with Jackie. So I'm proud to have her on the roster of great jazz singers.
Can never last, and when it's past, I'll be yours when she's gone.
I had a wonderful opportunity to have Jackie perform on probably the most successful concert that we've presented. We presented Aretha Franklin and invited Jackie to be the opening artist for that evening, which is always a difficult thing to do, especially with an iconic artist like Aretha Franklin. You know, sitting there in front of 3,600 people, all of whom had come to see Aretha. And Jackie got up on stage and won this audience over, I think within the first 10 seconds. Her elegance, you know, the vocal prowess, style. And she was so different and yet so complimentary to what Aretha was all about. It was much more successful, I think, than anybody would have imagined. And the audience brought her back.
I've heard Jackie for some 5 or 6 years, but I can come away and say, man, I enjoyed that concert tonight.
It's so nice to see that lineage continue.
For the last 3 weeks, she's been in my number one CD list, and I've listened to it over and over again.
Angels cheer because we're together, weather-wise. It's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds. And down to Acapulco, it's perfect for a flying honeymoon.
Well, I've known Jackie for about 15 years, and it's really been a pleasure to watch her grow and evolve as an artist and a performer, and just to develop so much confidence and authority in her work. I mean, she's always been a fine improviser, although not necessarily in the traditional jazz sense. She uses jazz improvisation, but she uses more popular material, and actually, I think, often moves as a pop artist would if they could improvise really well.
I can make all my desire, every memory is on fire, and I get a picture of all my yesterdays. Yesterday, I can say, I get a kick every time I see you gaze at me.
As a club owner, what I like about someone like Jackie is she's a good egg. I mean, she's just a great person to work with. When you're doing business and you say, okay, we have to do boom, 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 she gets it. I don't have to make a million phone calls. She's right on the same page and understands the business. There's a lot of jazz singers that come through the Green Mill, national acts, local acts. And the thing that's so special about Jackie, she has this magical connection to the audience that just draws them in. The place is packed, there's a line to get in, standing room only, and everyone's just enraptured in what she's singing. She controls the room, so to speak. And that's a great thing for us because we don't have to do any of the work. She's controlling the room, she has them under her thumb, and it's just a great thing.
Trouble from drinking juleps. As I was walking, I met a man. We started talking, went into a tavern to get a few nips. All I had was one mint julep. One mint julep, what caused it all?
She delivered every song with such a great jazz sensibility that I was immediately struck by the talent of this person, whom I had never heard, and who was Jackie Allen.
And what knocked me out is she did the slowest version I've ever heard of I'll Remember You, and I was almost in tears. She caught me immediately, and plus everything else she did. So we said, you're on Blue Note, and we proceeded from there.
The sun was setting over Avalon the last time we stood in the west. Suffering long-time angels, enraptured by Blake, burn up the drawers, innocence captured again. Standing on the beach at sunset, all the boats keep moving slow. In the glory